With some of the new features inside of Lightroom and Camera Raw, it's easier than ever to relight a scene. We're gonna do three things here. We're gonna even out the contrast between the really bright background and the darker foreground. We're gonna even out the white balance so that the color temperature is more consistent. And then we're gonna actually paint in some light. We're gonna create a rim light around our model and even a little beam of light coming in. Let's get started. Right now I'm using Lightroom, but you can also use Camera Raw. The develop module in Lightroom is identical to Camera Raw. And right now I'm creating a brand new Camera Raw course that's gonna be out soon. Drop a comment if you're interested. All right, so let's reduce the contrast between the foreground and the background area. The first we're gonna do is we're gonna take the highlights. We're gonna pull these down. Notice how that darkens the background. And now we're gonna take the shadow and increase that just a little bit. And that's giving us a little bit more brightness on the foreground. Now we wanna warm up the foreground. If you look in the background, it's a much warmer or more kind of a yellow color. In the foreground, it's more of a blue because it's in the shade. So we wanna warm this up, but we don't wanna overly warm up the background. So the way to do that, we're gonna choose a mask, and then we're gonna select all of the background. Now this will select everything except for our foreground, which is our model. Now we don't want to include this area in the back. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna choose subtract, and we're gonna grab a brush. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna hit the left bracket key a little bit to make it a little bit smaller. Make sure the feather is all the way up. This will give us a soft edge. Now I want to feather that soft edge across. See where the shadows kind of meet? Make sure auto mask is turned off. And then we're just going to paint away the rest of it. If the auto mask was on, it would be selecting individual areas and it would be very difficult to get a smooth kind of a blend. But now we are gonna use the auto mask because we wanna bring these areas back and protect them. So hold down the Alt or Option key. Notice that this right now it's a minus, now becomes a plus. Make sure auto mask is turned on, and this will select the edges and this will enable us to paint this part back in. Scroll down, choose the color temperature, and what we wanna do is just warm it up a little bit. Look at that. Brings back much nicer color. It's looking good. Now, the other thing I want to do though is I want to add a little more texture. This is why we didn't include the model. Yes, we do want to warm up the model as well, but we don't want to add texture to her skin because that would look bad. So now we can increase the texture, and this will put some kind of brings out the texture in this wood. See that? Looks really nice. And also it brings it forward, makes the image pop more as the background is more blurred. We're adding the perception of sharpening the foreground by bringing out this texture, and it just adds dimension. Great. So we've pretty much got our backdrop done. We're going to come back with some lighting in a little bit. Next thing we want to do is just do the basic lighting on our model. So we're going to choose Create New Mask, and we're going to select Subject. Now our model is the subject. Let's make that adjustment, the same adjustment in the temperature. So we're gonna warm it up just a little bit. There we go. See how that looks just so much better. And then what we're gonna do is we're going to just open up the exposure just a little bit, not too much, just a little bit. There we go, nice. And then I'm gonna take the contrast and take it down. Good. So now we've got some pretty good balanced lighting overall. This is where we start to get creative. What we want to do now is we want to create a rim light around our model where it looks like direct sunlight is actually hitting her, and then we'll make the environment match. So what we want to do is create a new mask for the rim light on our model. So we're going to create new mask and we're going to select subject. All right, so now that we've masked our model, a great way to create a rim light is to use the intersect option. So if we go under the mask here, we've got two ways. We could hold down the Alt or the Option key and choose Intersect, or we could click on the mask and choose Intersect. Now, Intersect means only where the two masks meet will there be an adjustment, only on that overlap. So if we choose the brush, if I click with my brush outside of that mask, notice what happens. If I go brighter or darker, nothing is happening. If I click within the mask, notice we lighten or darken that area. So I'm just going to quickly undo that. So that means only in the overlapping area is this going to appear. And this is exactly what we want. So what we want to do is we want to take our brush, and I'm going to take the exposure. I'm going to turn it up. So this will show us what's happening. And I want a soft edge brush. Number one, turn off auto mask. You don't want auto mask on. You want the feather and flow all the way up. And now what we can do is as we paint around this edge now, it's going to create a rim light. Watch this. Great. Now, obviously, it's too much because we've got that brightness turned all the way up. But that just enables us to see where we're painting. So let's create a little bit on the back here as if there's sunlight hitting. All right, let's make some adjustments. Let's bring that exposure back to a more reasonable level. Open up the shadows a little bit. And then to make it look like sunlight, we got to take that temperature and warm it up. There we go. Look at that. See how it's just kind of hitting her hair and her back now, like we've got some sunlight in there. This is looking good. All right, so why don't we do her arm? Now, we're just going to go over in some areas, and then we'll touch them up in a bit. So let's just go over on the arm. We've got sunlight hitting there, maybe a little bit on her foot here. All right, so obviously we've gone over in some areas, like some of these shadowy areas, we probably don't want that light in there. So what we can do is if we hold down the Alt or the Option key, and then hit the left bracket key to make this smaller, we can paint it away from some of the edges. So in here, if I don't want that light, we can paint it away. See that? Great. And now we can target exactly where we want that light. Let's put a little bit on her face. So I'm going to choose that brush. And then let's make some adjustments. One of the things I want to do here is I want to take this flow down. And this means that as I apply this, it's not going to apply it so quickly. So I can gently paint this in. And it's not necessarily going to apply 100%. Look at this. So we can get a smoother, softer kind of result where we just... There we go. Getting some sunlight on her face, but not overdoing it. Maybe a little bit on her cheek over here as it is missing her nose. Now what we want to do is we want to have some light hitting this porch because we've got this beautiful rim light that's kind of hitting her, but where is that light coming from? All right, so we're going to create another mask. And on this mask, we're going to use the object selection. And I love the object selection tool. This is really good. So we want to make sure we're in brush. And then with this brush, we can paint over these areas over here. And notice that that mask will detect those edges and say, oh, this is the area you wanted to mask out. And it is correct. That is what we wanted to mask. I'm going to add to that mask because I want to put a little bit more in here, like maybe a little bit behind her here and get that part. Great. Now we're going to intersect this again, choose the ellipses, and we're going to choose the intersect with brush. With auto mask turned off, feather and flow all the way up, we're going to kind of paint in some light here. So let's make this bigger. And then we're just kind of painting in here. See, we're just creating a nice little kind of bit of light there, and we're going to have that kind of hit the edges as well. All right, so let's do it. Let's add some light in here. Turn up the exposure a little bit. There we go. Now we've got some light coming in. Let's give it a little contrast. Let's crank up the texture because when it hits an edge like that, you're actually going to see more texture. And then, of course, the temperature is what's going to make this look believable. All right, and if we look at this image, here we were before, and there we are after. So hopefully you found this eye-opening. And by the way, I'm creating a new course in Camera Raw. Drop a comment and let me know if you're interested in that. By the way, if you found this useful and you learned anything new, let us know in the comments. Let's get a discussion going. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my videos. And do me a favor, hit that like button. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.